My name is Henry. I grew up in the kitchen baking with my mom. As I got older, I lost interest and went to go explore the world. Now I'm home trying to reconnect with my roots. This is Baking with My Mother. What are you going to teach me how to make today?
I thought we'd make popovers.
Nice. Yeah. I believe I've made these before, but I don't really remember how.
It's super, super simple. It's just like a really thin pancake batter that you bake in a special kind of pan, and then you put them in the oven and they blow up.
Okay, now are these all the ingredients we're going to need?
Yeah, that's it.
Sweet.
Super easy.
Let's go grab them.
All right, let's do it.
All right, so I grabbed everything. This is barely any ingredients.
Yep. You don't need much. Pretty much everybody already has this stuff in their pantry.
Yeah.
So it's just eggs and milk, butter, salt, and some flour.
Yeah, it's almost easy. Identical to pancake batter.
It's the same stuff, just different ratio. So
is there a method to how we're tossing it all in here? Is it just throw
just
it in?
Get it in the bowl.
Okay.
Just make sure it goes in the bowl. Tap. I usually tap the eggs on the counter just in case, so that way you're less likely to get shells in there, you know? Okay, so you get that in. I'll start whisking.
We got all our eggs in here.
Yep, whisk that together.
Now what are we gonna add
in? We're gonna just dump it. Where did you get this flour?
All purpose.
Great, perfect. All-purpose flour, dump that in. And get the milk going.
Do you want me to whisk and you pour in?
Sure. Okay. Make sure you're getting that stuff that's clinging to the edge there. And if it starts getting lumpy like that, you can always switch to an immersion blender. You can even do this in your blender.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, and I've got the immersion sitting right over here.
Yeah. So. Yeah, because that's taking a little bit.
Let me grab this. That'll be more fun anyways. Okay.
Just keep it in the bowl.
Oh, yeah. Let's try it. Making a mess, all right. Runny?
Yeah, that's exactly right. And it's nice and smooth. You don't have any lumps, so we're good to go.
Awesome. That was super easy.
So easy.
Let me grab the tray. And it's a special popover tray?
Yeah, you have to have the popover tray to get the right shape.
Okay.
The super cool shape. The other thing you need to do is get something. You can either ladle it in or put it in a measuring cup to pour it, or a pitcher.
Just something that'll make it easier to get it in there.
Yeah.
All right, let me grab that and then we'll get these in the oven.
Okay.
Sweet. So I got this in here. Do we just throw it right in there?
No. Well, first we've got to put butter in so that won't stick to it. But this is the popover pan. And then I just put like a little nub of butter in each little well. In the well, not on the counter. You want to do that?
I can throw a couple
like,
in there.
So it's like, I would say maybe a half teaspoon. Like that's too much.
Okay.
Although, just by a little bit. Like butter, the more butter you can get into a recipe, the better.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Yeah.
So yeah, get a good amount. And plus you don't want the popover batter to stick to the pan. So it's both for flavor.
This is Henry. So I'm editing right now. I realized the camera stopped and I didn't even know. So I'll give you a quick rundown. You put the butter in the pan and then you put the pan in the oven for around 2 minutes until the butter's melted, and then you can pour your dough in. Sorry about that. Back to the video. All right, so they're all melted down in there.
Yeah, bubbling, that's what you're going for.
Okay, that's really nice.
Then you just need to fill them up about 2/3 of the way full.
2/3.
Yeah, there you go. A little more. Perfect.
Like that?
Yep, that looks great. Because they're gonna sort of, all the egg in there is gonna explode.
Making a bit of a mess.
That's why I put the pan under it.
Okay. Sweet, and once you have them all full, you just pop them in there?
Yeah,
pop them in there. And how long are we gonna put them in there for?
About 20 minutes.
Okay.
We'll see how it looks.
I'll finish filling these and then we'll throw them in there.
Yeah, they look awesome. And look at all that pooling butter. It's awesome.
Looks great.
Maybe a tiny, some of these need a tiny bit more. Yeah, match them all up. Make sure that they're all the same height. So I said 2/3, but I think it's more like 3/4.
Okay.
So a little bit more.
So like almost to the edge.
Almost, yeah, but a little bit. You gotta just make sure all of them are the same amount so that they bake evenly. That's mm-hmm. the most important thing. And then bake them on a sheet like this, just in case they kind of overflow. That one looks like it needs more. Maybe, Alyssa, how much do you have left in there? Maybe we just touch them all up. I don't wanna go too high, but maybe those two need a tiny bit more. Yeah, because some of these are getting too full.
We'll All right, see. Like that?
Yeah. We gotta stop. Okay, let's try it.
I did
it. Fingers
good.
Crossed.
I'll throw them in there. Yeah. 20 minutes, you said?
20 minutes, 400 degrees, hot oven. Okay. Here, do it right on here in case they overflow. Okay. Plus it's easier to carry it, and I'll open the oven for you.
So, these came out crazy.
They're gorgeous. You totally nailed it. Look at that. They're like puffy and beautiful.
They came out awesome. Oh, look at that.
Yep. They stuck a little bit, but that's all right.
Yeah, maybe a tiny bit more butter.
Yes.
I grabbed some stuff to fill them with.
Perfect.
Some yogurt and jams and stuff. Let me close the oven quick.
Honestly, these are all about the condiments.
Yeah.
The jam.
Fill them with as much
butter,
stuff as you can.
Some cream. Get some tea. Yeah. Look. Perfect. Perfect.
That looks awesome.
Here, you want a plate?
Well, these came out awesome.
They're perfect.
Yeah.
They
thank
really
you
are.
So much for showing me how to do this.
Such a blast, dude.
This is really fun. And I think we're gonna do a lot more of these. So like, subscribe. You can leave a comment below and suggest any other videos you might want to see. I'll also leave a recipe for these and some links to get the popover pans. Just everything you might need.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you guys for watching.
Thanks.